What up, y'all? It's your boy Kill. I'm here with my main man, Evan. He used to be at Fly Club, and he's here at Adidas. So why don't you tell him, Evan, like, what's your position here now? I recently heard you got promoted.
Yeah, I'm up at Cash Wrap Supervisor. Blessed to be supervising Cash Wrap.
Beautiful. Now, you know what? I'm going to just flip this over. I'm going to be on the other side of the camera. So, Evan, you want to just tell the people, like, what is this event all about tonight here at the Adidas store on Melrose?
This event is geared towards drawing in the musical, artistic, creative culture that has been built in our area, in Los Angeles area, Melrose, Fairfax area, and really giving it a platform for multiple artists, multiple mediums to meet in one place and to get the community involved and see people chip off of each other's art, music, each other's design, and come together and network and see how we can expand and flourish into the next step.
That's right. Do you feel like the Adidas brand has always had the reputation of always working closely with artists?
Absolutely. I'm 24, you feel me? Since before I've been around, Adidas has definitely maintained a platform with its customer base and with the artists and artistry in general, really maintaining a relevance outside of any particular genre, but really, really reaching out to the artists and being a creative brand, you know?
Now, you're doing some of your artwork yourself, so I think we're going to put it on pause and we're going to ask Evan to kind of go in. And can you bring out some of your artwork and kind of describe it a little bit?
Yeah, man.
Exactly. We'll pause it just for a second to get this work done. Are we on, Evan?
So, yeah, here we have my, it's a quick little song, you know, just to represent the night. Melrose Art Night, you know, it's the name of the event. It's really the inspiration that myself and the team had, you know, everybody bringing it together. Shout out to the whole Adidas team for really staying focused on the message and the idea and bringing this to life. You know, a depiction of myself as a caricature, what I was providing tonight, doing caricatures for the customer base. And this is us, man. This is, we are creative. We start from scratch and we build what we're going to do. You know, we show them how it's done.
Awesome. Now, didn't you have some other drawing on the back or some other writing, or was that something?
That was my five minute wait. Yeah, my break message.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, is it true that people can come up to you and request for you to draw a drawing of themselves or what?
Absolutely. Outside of Adidas, you know, it's my company, but I'm a graphic artist and illustrator by trade. I've always been drawing, always been painting. You can always find me at Mr. Nixon, MSTRNXN, Mr. Nixon, and I'm always available. I'm an artist for life. If you need art, I got you.
That's awesome. Do you want to shout out any of your, like, social media stuff where people can find you?
It's at Mr. Nixon, pretty much any social network or platform, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. I'm not on Snapchat yet. But yeah, at Mr. Nixon, that's how you find me.
Any last words for the public before we go?
Shout out to my dog Kill for coming and showing love to my peoples, to me, you know, asking me the right questions. And I look forward to seeing everything come together. You know, so, salutes to Mr. Nixon.
Hey, we look forward to seeing you more, brother. You know what I'm saying?
Make sure everybody what I got on feet. Ooh. Pinnacle Four, son. Pinnacle Four.
So what's up, everybody? This is Kill again. We're inside the gallery now with my main man, the manager here at Adidas, the store here on Melrose. So I'm going to let him just introduce himself and do his thing. He's going to go into in-depth detail as to what this event is all about, why everybody's here today, as well as describe the artists and their work, as well as even talk about the past history that Adidas had with artists. I mean, they have a long history with that as well.
Absolutely.
So let's, without no further ado, let's give the attention to the man.
All right. What's up, everybody? My name is Jerron Ward, and I am the store manager of this beautiful location, Adidas Melrose here in Los Angeles. So pretty much tonight was all about community. You know what I mean? Like, that was the biggest thing and biggest inspiration behind the event that we put together. So what we did is, as Adidas Melrose, we really literally went out to the community and partnered with artists, genuine, real, authentic artists. You know what I mean? Like, individuals such as Mariella. We were blessed with this.
Wow.
A lot of, you know, story in general. And what she's able to contribute to us as far as inspiration has been huge, you know what I mean? So we're more than happy to have her here. And the main pillars that we had for the event tonight were LA music, LA culture, and LA community. So her biggest contribution obviously was LA music. So we got portraits of all the, I guess, key and influential individuals from Los Angeles right now. We got, you know, Odd Future, we got Frank Ocean, Tyler, the Creator, Earl Sweatshirt, of course, the legendary NWA, Snoop, Dom Kennedy, and then also just other inspirations as far as, like, Frank Hill, and people who've also inspired us, you know what I mean? So, and again, the main goal was to create something that's authentic and genuine that the community can really get involved with and be a part of. So that's really what it boiled down to. But I'll take you guys,
That was
a Lamborghini pulling off now. Right. So you know, what I mean?
And they were showing them love too. So you can see, not just artwork, but
it's the community, man. It's literally like community, and culture. You know what I'm saying? My guy right here, this is Mr. Nixon. He's actually one of the Adidas Melrose influencers. He's one of our key guys here, but he's here doing live artwork, doing caricatures of everybody here who wants a character on Picture Dot. He's doing that. This right here was actually contributed by the Love Crew, which is a really key and influential group that is here in Los Angeles. One of the main artists of the crew, his girlfriend actually works here. Her name is Gabby. So again, it's all homegrown, all home cultured.
That's beautiful, man.
They actually painted that specifically for this event. So they blessed us with a really dope piece with that as well, too. Let me keep showing you, man.
That's beautiful.
Matter of fact, I got one of the artists right here. I got two people right here. I got two people. This is one of the contributor artists as well, too. You want to show them the piece of the channel?
Okay. So you want to describe, introduce yourself and the artwork, brother?
Yeah, man. My name is Dre Kid. This is my piece. I just, like, call it the Woman Meets Machine. This is off my off the cutting room floor project. It's like I take discarded materials and paint over it.
Okay, yeah. So how long have you been doing this type of artwork?
This past year, I had a deal with the art dealer, and it went sour. The guy made me try to change my style or whatever.
Right.
And I got to do what's me. You know what I'm saying? So I basically told him we couldn't connect anymore. As soon as we got out of that deal and situation, I just started being more personal. Got back to being more personal with my art. Started taking materials my jeans, my shoes, and started putting it into my work, making it more personal with the portraits. And that's what it is. It's basically a representation of myself and it's expressing the personal aspect. Because a lot of times people, they want you to, they toss money at you, they want you to stop being yourself. And that's not what my art is about. That's not what I started doing it for. I started doing it as a way to vent, be able to express myself and keep my peace of mind. There's no point in doing it if I can't keep my peace of mind and my ownership of my art while I'm doing it.
Right.
So, yeah, I appreciate this type of thing where I can come out and just do me.
Yeah, appreciate it.
I'll let you introduce yourself, man, and kind of tell people who you are and the inspirations and why you're here, man.
Very stable in California, rapper, culture architect, and so I'm just here to help curate this event with Jerron and, add my little 2 cents and host, bring a good vibe. That's pretty much it in a nutshell.
Okay. We go way back. Okay. Way back. With music, culture, and just being a key influencer out here in Los Angeles, man. So I always bring Thursday whenever we do anything, man.
What was his name again?
Thursday with a G. Twitter, Thursday with a G.
I thought it was like third base, third.
Third.
With a Z.
Okay.
So I can keep it going, man. It's another piece right here.
Okay.
This is my fave. Was actually part of Shirt Kings, a really, really legendary crew. He started out of New York, but he's been out here in LA for 2 years.
Okay.
He's done airbrush up there for everybody from LA Cool J. LL Cool J to Big Daddy Kane. Pretty much the early 90s, he was one of the main influential voices of hip-hop culture from a fashion perspective. So he came through and blessed us with a cool little piece. All custom done for this event as well, too. So I got a couple.
Man,
It's like MTV Cribs up in here.
Yeah, man, we got friends everywhere, dog. So yeah. This right here is actually a high
school. Oh wow.
Yeah.
So actually,
okay.
This is actually her artwork.
Okay.
She is a high school student at the moment. So she came through and blessed us with some really great work. So again, our goal to really incorporate the community is showing up right here. You know what I mean? So
yeah, you want to describe your artwork?
Thank you for letting me have my art here.
Yeah, for sure. I don't know if you want to kind of describe like your inspirations or how long you've been doing art, like just that kind of journey.
Well, like a lot of my inspiration, I guess it's like what musically too, it's a big influence also, like my family and friends, stuff like that. But like usually I dream a lot, so a lot of my dreams go into like my work and what I'm feeling at the moment, so that's some of what my art goes to.
Okay, so both of this section is you?
Yeah, this is me, and then that piece over there is my culture trip from Colombia. So
okay. And then what about this one?
This one, I had a dream that I saw her face and I could fit her, and then each color represents how we feel as an individual. Sometimes I feel envious, angry, hopeful. Yeah.
Okay, and then this one right here, see? Is that Gerald Butler?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Alright.
Well, thank you so much for your contribution. I'm glad you had a chance to be involved. And, I mean, we just continue to thank you, so appreciate
you.
Oh, that's a nice shot right there. That's probably the best shot of the night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So this right here is a trip down like trippy land, you know what I mean? But it's actually created by somebody here, but she does actual artwork through pieces. This is literally furniture. It's furniture, you know what I mean?
So play on words.
Yeah, literally. So she did this nice piece for us and contributed. So I love the abstract nature of it. I love the fact how it's kind of shocking because it's so different. It's eye catching immediately, but then it's just dope. You know what I mean? And it goes perfectly with the brand as well too. So
yeah, I was hoping you guys could have some Yeezy 350s because they got the orange stripe, but it probably would be good. So
those come out tomorrow. We got them. That's for tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm high security on those.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, let me introduce the vaccine right quick too.
I like that. Vaccine.
Yeah.
Not only do they have cool drawings, they got cool names.
They're artists, man. But he contributed this piece of Tupac.
Yeah.
Obviously,
is he still alive?
Somewhere.
You know, he's still alive.
I saw that, and that actually looks decent. You know what I mean? Like, I'm super skeptical. Like, I honestly think that Tupac is one of the hardest individuals to play, to act.
Yeah, because it looked like him too.
Yeah, his personality was so authentic and so real that it's hard to manufacture that. You know what I mean? But we'll see, man. We'll see. But he contributed, you know, one of the.
I couldn't necessarily say in terms of Tupac's essence. I mean, I like a lot of
him. Yeah, this actually
looks like a photograph, but he didn't. Yeah, I mean, I've never really moved that way. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I see your art and it's dope, that shit inspires me.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
These pieces were contributed by Ben Davis. He's actually a live artist here in Los Angeles.
Okay.
Very, very light brother. It's a pretty positive, quite big, man. Great smile on his face. Such a positivity. He's one of our friends.
Okay.
Personally, so
we're happy to have this contribution as well too. Again, community, and culture. You know what I mean?
That's the biggest pillars of the day.
Man, that's cool, brother. Man, you know, we would have known not about this.
This piece is epic. This is done by J.C. Rowe. He's a man of murals on the side of Dom Gallery and one of our other shit stores up the street. This is a picture of Kanye painting 350. Also inspired by the concept that he's done. Kanye has painted a picture of Kanye.
Okay.
It's very Kanye.
Right.
He's painted a picture of my friend, Kanye.
Right.
And then they said to tell me that this is supposed to be Kim Kardashian. This is the waist to figure out Kim Kardashian.
Oh, okay. I think we can figure that out.
Yeah. That's where that came from. So he.
What about that last piece?
My Dark Twisted Fantasy.
Oh,
okay. I think that's where that comes from. So there's different pieces of like album work, and then Kanye. Of course, 350 by himself.
that's a heavy piece of art. I mean, you're gonna have this, you're gonna still have this on for a minute, right?
He's gonna break this one down, but this other piece, we're gonna keep this one. Because we got Yeezys coming up tomorrow. This will be the last piece right here. This is another piece by J.C. Rowe.
Let's bring it in slowly.
Yeah. You gotta definitely marvel at that one.
Wow.
We're gonna hold on to this one for a couple of days because we got Yeezys coming up tomorrow.
Right.
We're gonna get lots of centerpiece.
Man, that's awesome, brother.
Man. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you know what you're getting into, champ.
Last but not least.
You might wish to finish talking with your
hair. All right, this is publishing of the and this inspiration for this one is tons of different faces, variety, and diversity. And it's centered on the
logo.
So,
yeah, you know where to come.
Yeah. We're definitely happy with the turnout. Happy with the vibes. Happy with the energy, man. And you know, the city's always welcome, man. So we thank you, everybody. And you know, come holler at us, man. We always here.
It's beautiful. Thank you, brother. All right. So here's one of the artists. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
What's going on, people? My name's Vaxxene, V-A-K-S-E-E-N, and you know, I'm an artist. I'm a creator. I paint abstract portraits that look like they're collage, but they're really fully hand-painted, and the style's called Vanity Pop. This is one of my pieces right here, Love Hate. One of my paintings, you see I do merch as well, but it's all original hand paintings. I mean, these stickers, that's another piece. Today's the day I realized. And then, you know, my Pac painting that everybody was flipping out over tonight.
Yeah,
it's a sticker of
colors on there too.
Yeah, man. The Shakur State, they featured this in their official Tupac exhibition last year. 20 artists worldwide, and I was one of them. So, just a blessed artist out here working, living my dreams. You know.
Thanks for the time, Vaxxene.
Thank you.
All right.